Hi, my name is Lila, also known as Lila from YouTube, and I'm here today with Epidemic because we're going to learn everything we need to know about the new export mode in Premiere Pro 2022. Premiere Pro has had a big upgrade this year where they revamped the entire editing workflow. The previous export mode was a little bit complicated, which is why they simplified it, and I'm going to be guiding you through each step. Assuming you're using the latest version of Premiere Pro, you've probably noticed this header bar right here. It says import, edit, and export. So let's open up the export mode, and as you can see, we now get a full screen export window versus the pop-up screen that we got before. On the left side, there are a lot of destinations. You do not just have to export your video as a media file, you can actually also simultaneously upload it to your favorite social media platforms. So for demonstration purposes, I want to export this video as a media file, but I also want to upload it to YouTube. As you can see, for YouTube, you can enter all of the metadata so you don't have to wait for the video to be uploaded in order to then add the metadata such as title and description. And as you can see, you can even select your thumbnail right here. When it comes to uploading your video to social media, by default, Premiere Pro will recommend the best preset for that specific platform so you don't have to spend any time Googling, finding out what bitrate settings, which we will get into in a second. So essentially, this means that you're ready to go. However, if you prefer more control over the settings, we can do that too. All the export settings are customizable, which means that you can get the file exactly as you or your client wants. For now, let's assume that the YouTube settings are fine the way that they are, so let's head over to the media file and change some settings there. The first two settings we'll see is file name and location, which are pretty self-explanatory. We can choose a preset right here, such as Apple ProRes or Match Source, which is a pretty great option if you've already customized your sequence settings. Instead of using a preset, we're going to dive into all of the settings and we're going to find out what they do and how to use them. Right below preset, we see format. And what I would recommend is to set this to H.264 because this is widely accepted and this is what a lot of people use. Then there's a bunch of tabs that we can enable and we can open up to customize all settings. Now, if for example, you don't want or you don't have any captions or additional effects like a watermark or a time code, then you can just toggle it off. In this case, we want to make sure that we have both video and audio toggled on as we want to export a video with audio. Let's open up the video tab, and what we can do is we can actually customize each setting like I said before. So we can change the frame size by unchecking this box right here and then changing the values. Same goes for frame rate and basically all the other options. However, I do recommend to make sure that these settings match the source settings. Then we have field order and aspect, and I always just leave it the way that it is. I never really touch it. Now we can click on more to get even more settings. In case this gets overwhelming, I have a little tip that's really going to help you out. If at any point you forget what a certain setting does, what you can do is just hover over the word and it will tell you exactly what it does. The first option is render at maximum depth. By default, this is unchecked. Now you do want to check it if you want overall better quality and you want to avoid any banding issues. Now this box is especially important if in project settings you chose software rendering. By ticking this box, you're rendering in 32-bit, which just simply means that you're avoiding any banding issues or any clipping issues. The next one is use maximum render quality. Now when we hover over it, it tells us gives better quality scaling but increases encode time. By default, just like the previous one, this one is also unchecked. If you have a GPU and you mostly use GPU accelerated effects, then this setting is mostly irrelevant because the GPU will already give you that performance. However, you should consider checking this box if 1) you're like me and you reposition, you rotate, or you scale up or down a lot, and therefore your sequence frame size and or aspect ratio doesn't match the frame size and aspect ratio of all of the clips that you used, and 2) if you're not exclusively using GPU accelerated effects. Now, if you check any of these boxes, make sure that you check the box use maximum render quality. Render alpha channel only is irrelevant unless you're exporting an animation with a transparent background, like this one for example, so in this case we're gonna leave it unchecked. Now, as you can see, you can choose between hardware and software encoding. Hardware encoding is the way to go if you have a good graphics card and you want the fastest export time. I use the M1 Max MacBook Pro, so this is what I do when exporting my videos. Of course, you can also choose software encoding, but that will make the export time a lot slower. All right, here we can choose our profile and we're gonna set it to high. And now let's scroll down to the bitrate settings. This will determine the quality of your videos and the size of the video file. There's a few settings here. We have CBR and we have VBR. Now CBR stands for constant bitrate and VBR stands for variable bitrate. Without getting too technical, what this means is when you choose CBR and you choose a constant bitrate, this means that no matter what happens in your video will be exported at a certain bitrate. Now, the higher you set this bitrate, the bigger the file size will be, but also the better the quality. If you choose VBR, then this means that the bitrate will either increase or decrease depending on what your media file needs during the encoding process. Now, as you can see, when it comes to VBR, there are two different options. We have VBR 1-pass and VBR 2-pass. 1-pass means that it will pass through the video once and it will kind of guess where the bitrate should be in order for the video to be encoded properly. Now, 2-pass means that it will go through the video, you guessed it, twice, which will take more time, but it is optimal because you will get the smallest file size, but also the best quality possible. What you need to choose and what bitrate settings will work best for your video really depends on what you're using your video for and if you're uploading it to any social media platforms, for example, and if so, what social media platform, because it all differs. So therefore, I recommend to look up what the best bitrate settings are for the purpose of your video and take it from there. Now, in general, for YouTube, the target bitrate should be between 35 and 45 for 4K videos. However, for short form videos, if you want to upload it, for example, to Instagram Reels or Instagram Stories or TikToks, these platforms usually compress the video a little bit more, so you want to take that into account. All right, we're done with all of the video settings, so let's move over to the audio settings. Now, by default, this already looks pretty good. I suggest to use the AAC audio format as it is higher quality than the MPEG. Now, when it comes to sample rate, you want to make sure that the sample rate that you're selecting here matches the sample rate of the source. To check this, you can go down here where it says source and then make sure that these two numbers match. Stereo is fine, and now what we want to do here is we want to increase the bitrate to the maximum that is available because obviously, again, we want the best audio quality. Now, if you're exporting a video on an Apple computer, you want to go to effects, you want to toggle that on, and then check the box in front of Lumetri Look / LUT. Click on the drop-down menu, click select, and then choose the QT Gamma Compensation. The main reason why you want to add this LUT if you're on an Apple computer is because without it, you will see that the colors of your exported video will look a little bit different than the colors in your edits. But if you're using Windows, you're fine without it, you can skip this step. Now, if you will use these export settings more than once, then I highly recommend you to create a preset. In order to do this, we go back up to preset, click on the three dots next to the drop-down menu, and then click on Save Preset. Now, if we go back to the beginning of the video where we discussed that we can simultaneously upload this video to different social media platforms, the same steps apply, unless of course you just want to use a preset. Then all there's left to do is hit export, and congratulations, you have just exported your video. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.